in Dallas, and Charlie Waters, it was Redskin fans marching.
There's no fights or anything going on out there.
Maybe it's Texas Longhorn fans deserting their club.
Well, there's a new mood with both of those teams, and let's go to Irv Cross. Irv?
As the Cowboys and Redskins prepare to face each other again today, it was hard to believe they were getting ready for another head-on collision. The Cowboys were acting as though they never met a Redskin they didn't like, and in Washington, the mood was strictly ho-hum. It was an upside-down time at Redskin Park. Here it is, Cowboy Week, and the players couldn't get themselves psyched up for it. Some of the guys were actually smiling, while others watched the dating game instead of game films. Is the rivalry dead? What's going on here?
It's kind of hard to put your finger on. I've never been able to tell moods very well.
Yeah, we're looking at it as just another game. You know, we never really get caught up in all the hype.
Even the sight of so many banged up Cowboys on the injured list couldn't convince the Redskins that they should turn the other cheek this week.
Dexter, do you feel sorry for the Cowboys because they're all injured right now?
I think they listed Landry on the injury list too, you know, and he may be over there in a sling trying to con us a little bit.
Sorry to disappoint you, Curtis, but Tom Landry's doing just fine, thank you. And rumors that the Redskins, along with the Washington media, was more interested in the Iceland summit than the Dallas game were also quickly denied.
Ronald Reagan who? In Washington, it's the Redskins. Redskins are an institution in this town, and I think that speaks over the Congress, the White House, all the other trick-a-dicks around.
In Dallas, the media hoopla surrounding the Redskin game was also missing due to the summit. But down here, it's a different kind of summit.
It's the Texas OU showdown that's riled people up this week in the Big D. As for the Cowboys, they're keeping their chins up after the big loss to Denver. The mere thought of the Redskins has helped some of the injured recover. Washington may be indifferent, but the Cowboys look ready.
Redskin week is a big week for us, and if anything I'd like more, is to be playing against the Washington Redskins.
I don't think the rivalry has died down. Both teams are just kind of taking a neutral stance right now and not saying too much to get the other team fired up.
With all the bad blood that's flowed, Landry has put a muzzle on the players. Speak kindly or don't speak at all.
Joe Gibbs is a pretty good guy. It's hard to get mad at him.
It's as if the coach told the guys, if the Redskins provoke you, walk away from it.
When it comes on Sunday, it's one-on-one, and you got to hit somebody in the mouth to win a football game.
Now, those guys, you know, you try to hit them in the mouth. If you miss, they're gone by you. And that's something that I have to contend with.
With everything low-key, the Redskins thought they could just slip into town yesterday. They also brought some boosters with them. But even if the cowboy policy has been to grin and bear it, no one clued in their fans.
Well, I don't like the Redskins at all, and Dallas is going to kill them today.
Of course, a big story down here. Everybody's been talking about the Cowboys' injuries all week long. The Redskins come into this game pretty well banged up, too, particularly on defense. There's some question about whether or not starting middle linebacker Neil Okowicz can go on a bum knee. So I don't think that's going to take away the edge of any ball club here, any player here, though, because they're all souped up. It'll be a battle of the walking wounded down here, Brent.
All right, everything. Charlie, I never know when I watch the Cowboys if they're going to play with emotion or not.
Well, they're hard to judge. Even on the games when we were really high when I was playing, we'd go out and play bad, and some days we would kind of sleep through the practices and go out and play with a lot of energy, so it's hard to tell.
Can you tell in the moments before the kickoff?
No, you really can't. It takes the first series or so before you can tell where the energy is really lying and who's got the control of it.
All right, we'll continue with the NFL Today on CBS in just a moment. So we're set for a full lineup of football. I want to remind you fans watching up in New England, New York State, and much of the state of Florida that you will rejoin us later this afternoon for the Giant Eagle confrontation. And also the summit meeting continuing over in Iceland, and CBS News will be updating that story throughout the afternoon. So for Jimmy the Greek and Charlie Waters, Irv Cross and Will McDonough, I'm Brent Musburger. We'll see you later, everybody. Welcome back to New York. You know, later today, there's a big Eastern Division confrontation between the Giants and the Philadelphia Eagles. Now, the Eagles have recently been playing like giant killers, knocking off two unbeaten teams in a row. And as Irv Cross now tells us, that hardly seemed possible in the early days of the year when they were an embarrassment to themselves and to their outspoken new coach, Buddy Ryan.
When the season began, the loudest noise in Philadelphia was Buddy Ryan's voice, filling the air with bold predictions that the Eagles would win their division. But their first three games were a dismal story of broken promises. The team not only looked awful, but even worse, badly coached.
Morale wasn't very good within the city. I mean, everyone was pointing fingers and blaming the team and Buddy and everybody else. But I think through that kind of adversity, a team comes together.
Even the players had doubts about their new coach. And the Philadelphia Press was quick to fan the flames of discontent. Every day the presses roll, and every day the Philadelphia media painted a dismal picture of Ryan's Eagles. The Buddy system wasn't working. But after three straight losses, the unexpected happened. All of a sudden, the Eagles are playing up to the level of Ryan's reputation, and despair gave way to a new upbeat mood.
He had a game plan when he came here. He wanted to go with the people that he felt he could line up and play with and win with. And obviously, he hurt some feelings along the way, but he had a game plan and he's executed it.
To gain firm control of the team, Ryan cleared out the Eagles' nest, releasing some veterans and benching others who suddenly had to fight for starting positions they had taken for granted.
I was very upset, you know, when he came in. I was second team, I wasn't playing, and I never was second team in my life. But one thing I realized is that you have to sit back and give a man a chance and try to understand where he's coming from.
When you're accustomed to starting for a while, sometimes you can get a little lackadaisical, sometimes you can lose your motivation, and I don't know if that necessarily happened, but certainly not having the job made me hungrier to get it back.
Now with two straight victories, the Eagles have become Ryan's Express. But Buddy himself hasn't changed a bit.
I'm still the same guy I was then. I think it's just that players may have thought it was that way because of practice, but I'm the same guy I was before.
He's still the same Buddy Ryan. And I don't think anybody's quite figured out, you know, where he's coming from.
The most important thing is not that I love him, but I respect him.
Charlie Waters, what about when a new coach takes over a team as far as the players are concerned?
Well, there's always big question marks in their mind. He came out and changed his whole style. And a lot of coaches have different styles of doing things, and of course his style is a lot different than what they've been used to. But I like what I'm hearing from these players, and he's producing now.
Yeah, he's certainly produced in Chicago. The Bears have replaced the Dallas Cowboys as America's team, Charlie.
Excuse me?
what do you think about the way the Bears play?
Well, they are an extension of Mike Ditka, and I know Mike Ditka real well and played with him for about 10 years, and he's very fiery, and he shows his emotions, and it shows all the way across the board, and they're winning with it, and that's the good thing.
Charlie, let's get everybody up to date with the activity around the National Football League. As you know, the Bears leading by only 7 at the half. They were favored by up to 14 points in some quarters. The Lions and the Packers right now, they are late into their halftime. It is 14-7. In fact, they have started the second half. 14-7, the Lions with a lead in that game. The Jets are all over the Patriots. This one's hard to believe because the Jets are without O'Brien. Ryan's the quarterback. They dominated the clock for all but 35 seconds in the opening quarter. New Orleans has jumped on Indianapolis. It is 10-0. They're at the half of that game. Miami, Marino to Duper, 30 yards, puts the Dolphins in front of the Bills, 10-7, and they have started the second half down in the Orange Bowl. St. Louis, Tampa Bay, the Cardinals have missed a field goal opportunity and an extra point that could come back to haunt them in the second half. Kansas City and Cleveland now, they have started the second half. They are deadlocked at 7. Atlanta over the Rams, 10-7, and it was the big fella Gerald Riggs who got the job done for Atlanta on the go-ahead touchdown in that game. Now, Dallas and Washington, as we see first, we're going to check in on John Robinson and the Rams. And from the shotgun, it is Steve Bartkowski. And here's the touchdown pass to Michael Young, his second score of the season. But again, as I said, the big fellow Riggs, so hard to stop, Charlie.
Well, they have that ground game at Atlanta, and their quarterback, as long as he doesn't throw interceptions, they have a chance to win the ball games. They have a powerful running game.
Indeed they do. And that's the count there in halftime, 10-7. And now, the Cowboys and the Redskins, and the Cowboys have been very impressive. What about Herschel Walker, Charlie?
Well, he can do everything, Brent. Of course, people are going to get tired of hearing about him, but you better be ready for it because he can do it all. Plur on this play, scrambles out, throws deep. Ball's on the throw, but look the way Herschel comes back, breaks three tackles right there, and scrambles down to about the 1-yard line.
Now, what about his ability inside the five? What's he got going for him?
Well, he's quick to get to the outside, and you'll see on this play, it makes the linebacker think he's going to the outside with his speed, and then he knifes back in there with power. So Herschel Walker can do it all.
All right, and it is 16-0. Cowboys over Redskins. Like Charlie Waters says, he can do it all. The NFL Today continues after these messages from your local stations.